Beach. We make it available to our neighbors in the Beach and Manhattan Beach as well.
Now watch.
take the roof off.
Water pump carries just a little bit of water out of the lot. It is not a specialized firefighting tool. It's more than considered to be our rolling toolbox. The next thing we're doing is we're using the cutters. Cutters come with about 50,000 pounds of pressure. And our general rule is if you can get it between the teeth of the cutters, you cut it. Not matter if it's a piece of wood, a piece of steel, and you'll see it cuts really effectively through there. Now, as we're making our cuts, what our concerns are, particularly on newer cars, you've got the actuators for the seat belt, and you also have the airbag. And each of those have explosives that trigger the seatbelt actuator or the airbag. So the button on the top, trying to avoid what we call the B pillar, or that middle pillar, because again, we're not sure each car's different, each manufacturer is different. We're not sure where those lines run. The other challenge that we have on cutting our cars, not only do we have to worry about the airbag being deployed, we also have to worry about the pneumatic bumpers or the crash test bumpers. They also are having explosive charge in them. So what we're doing now is it's a pretty quick operation. We're going to take the roof off the car. Again, it'll give us really good access. Not uncommon when we have a significant traffic accident. The driver will be pinned by the steering wheel or their feet or legs pinned up to the dash. So the more room we have to take to work inside the vehicle, the more effectively and quicker we can get you out. Our whole goal is if we have to cut somebody out of the car, they're going to be
we just looked funny. There was
no.